Hi viewers, myself Al Jazeera, Assistant Professor in Microbiology Department. Welcome to E-Content Development Center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Puramannur. The topic I would like to discuss in this video, Environmental Microbiology, is a part of open course of the Department of Microbiology. Following topics are discussed in this video: fecal contamination, indicator organisms, waterborne diseases. By learning the content, the students will be able to understand the concept of environmental microbiology, to know about fecal contamination of water, indicator organisms, coliforms, and waterborne diseases. Let me start with an introduction of microbiology. What is microbiology? Which deals with the study of microorganisms. It is not visible with the naked eye. This have a bacteria, fungi, virus, and protozoa. In this, bacteria have a different shapes: bacilli, coccae, vibrio, and spirilli shapes. First one is coccae. Coccae is the round shaped organism. Bacilli is the rod shaped organism. Vibrio, which have a coma shape, and the spirilli have a zigzag shape of the organisms. Then the environmental microbiology. What is environmental microbiology? The environmental microbiology, which consists of soil microbiology, air microbiology, water microbiology, and industrial microbiology, and various part of the science. Next is the coliform bacteria. The coliform bacteria, which is defined as the facultative anaerobic non-spore-forming gram-negative rod-shaped organism, which can ferment the lactose with the gas formation. Commonly found in lower intestine of warm-blooded organisms. With the presence of the coliform bacteria in water, which can indicate the fecal contamination, example Escherichia coli and Klebsiella. This is how it looks under the microscope. Next is the waterborne diseases. By the ingestion of contaminated water, which will cause a variety of diseases, is known as waterborne diseases. The pathogenic organisms are bacteria, viral, and protozoa. These diseases can be classified into three types: bacterial diseases, viral diseases, and protozoal diseases. Next is the bacterial diseases, which have various type of diseases: cholera, salmonellosis, typhoid, shigellosis, etc. First one is cholera. It is caused by Vibrio cholerae. It's a coma-shaped organism. It's a severe acute intestinal disease. Their incubation is 1 to 3 days. The bacteria can adhere to the intestinal mucosa and to produce a cholerogen toxins. Their symptoms is vomiting, fever, watery stools, rapid dehydration, acidosis, and collapse. Second one is typhoid, which is caused by Salmonella typhi. It is a gram-negative motile organism. Their incubation period is 10 to 14 days. The organisms can enter into the small intestine and multiply and penetrate to the intestinal epithelium and spread to the lymphoid tissue, blood, liver, and gallbladder. The symptoms is the fever, diarrhea, malaise, and enlargement of spleen and lymphoid tissue. Next one is salmonellosis. The disease is caused by Salmonella typhi murium. It's a gram-negative bacilli. Their incubation period is 6 to 48 hours. The organisms can enter into the small intestine and penetrate to the epithelium and to produce exotoxin and cytotoxin, which can degrade the epithelial cells. Their symptoms: fever, diarrhea, and abdominal cramps. Next one is botulism, which is caused by Clostridium botulinum. The incubation period is 12 to 36 hours. The organism can produce the botulinum toxin, the disease known as foodborne botulism, which mainly affect on the nervous system. These symptoms is blurred or double vision, poor reflection, and weakness. Next one is shigellosis, caused by Shigella dysenteriae. It's a gram-negative bacilli. Their incubation period is 24 to 48 hours. The organism produces cytotoxin is known as Shiga toxin. Their symptoms: diarrhea, fever, muscle contraction, frequent stool containing, pus, mucus and blood. Second one is viral diseases, which have various types of diseases. First one is hepatitis A diseases. In this, the causative organism is hepatitis A virus. Their incubation period is 2 to 4 weeks, which can mainly affect in the gallbladder. The symptoms is diarrhea, vomiting, fever and the yellowing of skin and eye. The next is hepatitis E, caused by hepatitis E virus. Then the incubation period is 2 to 4 weeks. Their symptoms is vomiting, fever, yellowing of skin and eye. They multiplies in gallbladder and excreted through feces. Third one is protozoal diseases, which have various type of diseases. First one is amoebic dysentery, which is caused by Entamoeba histolytica. Their incubation period is 2 to 4 weeks. It's a intestinal infectious diseases, with their symptoms is abdominal pain, diarrhea. Next one is giardiasis, which is caused by Giardia lamblia. Their incubation period is 1 to 2 weeks. It's a intestinal infection. Their symptoms is abdominal pain, diarrhea and nausea. We have discussed about fecal contamination, indicator organisms, coliforms and waterborne diseases. Hope all of you understood. Thank you.